Hello everyone, welcome to Open Source Summit Japan. Today I'm going to talk about supporting complex NoPDSA bridges in Linux system. Little bit about myself. I'm basically an embedded Linux engineer. I work for various embedded Linux products and software development since from last 12 and a half years. I have founded a company in India called Amoda Solutions. Here we are developing open source Linux software solutions to the customers all over the world. Technically, I'm more interested towards open source area, so I have given my talks, paper presentations, and technical demos on various embedded Linux conferences over the world since from the 2013. I myself supporting several contributions in Ubuntu and Linux projects. And there are some key subsystems in those project areas as well. Come to the actual topic. This is one of the topics that we are working right now with our embedded customers in industries. So far from since almost 2.5 years. All this presentation is purely demonstrated by technical requirements, like we have given all this information based on our real-time experiences rather than the theoretical ones. So most of the hardwares and the software that we are developing are mostly for consumer and industrial-based embedded systems which uses MIPDSI. So I will first talk about why these MIPDSI bridges are required and what are those bridges basically in the hardware point of view, like how those bridges can be used in the hardware point of view in the fields, and then I will start about how those hardware bridges has been developed in the Linux software with the help of Linux DRM core. I will thoroughly explain each and every part of DSA bridges so far in the technology as per the MIPI standard. And I can start giving the various implementations of these bridges in the Linux kernel. And finally, I will give an information overview of how these bridges has been probing or enumerating in the Linux boot processor in the module perspective. As I said before, all this information I have given is strictly based on my experience. Something which may face any issues are not related to in this presentation. Like as per my knowledge and as per my experience so far with the Linux DRM bridge. Let us start with the MIPDSI bridges. Why MIPDSI bridges are required basically? If you understand the embedded perspective, MIPDSI is one of the display interface standard. Like we have the parallel communication or parallel RGB, and we have another technology called LVDS, HDMI, display port, all these sort of display interfaces. MIPDSI is a versatile one, which has its own several advantages with respect to embedded world mostly, because these bridges are powered by low power and high performance. That even the protocol perspective, this is pretty much simple what we have been master slave communication that is done by normal networking. Like master is sending the data by with a handshake and slave can receive that data and give an update based on the React and NAC, something like that. So Why exactly these bridges are required in the consumer and industrial perspective? I have categorized based on my experience, and these are the bridges that I have been seeing so far with respect to my working and even for the and the technological perspective. One is the complexity of host display controllers. If you see these nowadays, all these SoC vendors are coming up with a simple display interface controller, give the overhead or headache to the end user so that they can use their respective display interface. What I mean to say is they go with the generic display interface like BPDSI. So they don't need to handle any controllers for LVDS or HDMI, even for other IPs, other display IPs. So the consumer can take use of a SOC with the BPDSI. They can make use of different interfaces like LVDS, HDMI by using some kind of a bridges to convert them basically. That is another point where complexity of voice display controller is coming to picture. Take an example of IMX 8 Mini and Exynos 54. Both have implemented their own DSA host controllers. Even the protocol is a MIPI standard. So it is a redundant technique to make use of the same IPs even though it's a different SoCs. That is where one of the complexities occurs basically. If some other SoC wanted to use some other display host controller, they need to re-implement everything. And at the end of the day, it is almost 80 to 90% of identical as part of the MIPI DSA spec. So there is a complexity occur. That is one point. And there is another point where if SoC has a DSA, but the end user wants to have a different display interface, say for example, HDMI or LVDS. In that case, there is a proximity of problem like MIPI DSA cannot send HDMI data, something like that. That is one of the interface conversation and compatibilities. And there is other use case where one single interface can outputting to multiple outputs rather than a single output. So the typical example of this was like the same controller can make use of two different identical outputs so that they can use the two different display interfaces. That is where one of the key requirement of this DSA bridges is required. The other perspective, this is one of the things that has been recently observed. There is a concept called switching, that DSA switching, where basically we need to output only one display interface, but the consumer or end user wants to have a multiple outputs in a single instant, like they want to support LVDS and HDMI on their own. Like of course they cannot use both the interfaces at the same time, but they wanted to do some kind of a switching, like I want to turn on one and I want to turn on the other, something like that. And there is another advantage, another requirement where apart from the standalone displays, there is another kind of a display called the projectors. And the typical example of embedded is DLP projectors, where there is a huge advantages for MIPI DSA because of this protocol advantages like low power, high performance, as I said below before. So this is also one of the key area where MIPI DSA is coming to picture basically. Coming to the real implementations of those, if you see, the host complexity can be avoided by using a DSA host bridge. Take an example of this IMX8M and Exynos 54. Both they use their own PIs. Of course, the PI layer is most typically relevant to that particular SOC, but they come up with a common bridge basically. That is Samsung MIPI DSI bridge. So that common bridge can, what I'm meant to say here was like the host bridge can be compatible with the different SoCs. So the same IP can be redundantly used for the several SOCs. This is because of its MIPI DSA specifications. Because the bridge itself is designed based on the spec. So the complexity of using the several DSA hosts can be reduced basically. And the second one, that is the display interface output, where DSI to HDMI converter. This is one of the kind like converter bridge. And the other one is something like giving a multiple outputs, like taking a single input from the SOC and giving multiple outputs. This is one of the other bridge example, like multi-output bridge. There are some real use cases about these basically. There are other kind of a other interface type, like display interface switch, where it has mentioned like I need to switch the several interfaces each at a single time. That is another category of a DSA bridge switch. So finally, there is another advantages with respect to the non-standalone panels like projectors. They have a DLP technology from Texas Instruments that would come up with the DSA DLP bridges. These are the different category types of different MPDSA bridges. So far, I have seen in the technology usage. This is perspective. Yeah, these are the things I'm merely called as based on my understanding, but the meaning of these are more or less similar to what we have there in this tech basically. The first one I call it as a host bridge, since it is not used in the slaves, so it's strictly an option for SoC vendors. Here NXP and Samsung have been using the same DSM bridge on their SOCs. That means they have used a common bridge to access their SoC display interfaces. Another one is a converter bridge. There is another bridge that converts DSA to HDMI. Right now I'm working on this particular bridge where it takes the MPDSA input and it converts to HDMI transmit. That is used for HDMI display monitors. And there is another bridge which is already been submitted in mainline, that is called SN65DS84 from Texas Instruments. What it takes the single input from the SOC and it will convert into multiple outputs, like two outputs, so you can able to drive two different display interfaces of LVDS. This is also kind of a converter, but it converts DSA to multi LVDS. There is another type of the bridge where bridges switching can happen from LT8912. There are several design challenges going to happen with respect to bridges. It wants to switch the LVDS and HDMI. It is at every time, in a single time basically. The last bridge is DLPC3433, that is from Texas Instruments. It is widely used on DLP projectors. So you can be able to use those projectors on the DLP bridge. So the projector have a high performance and low power methodologies. Let me talk about briefly on the hardware perspective, how these can be implemented to internal to the protocol here. Start with the Samsung DSMMS bridge. This is a purely host bridge. Here you can see the host can connect to the interface controller. Like here I'm connecting one interface controller IC with the DSA panel. Here the data communication, as I said, the MIPI DSA protocol standard is like master slave communication. Like master can send the data with respect to a data lane along with the clock lane latch. And slave can receive the data with respect to their master behavior, something like a handshaking kind of a communication. This is a typical example connection on how this host DSMI bridge has happened basically. This is the IT6161 converter bridge, where the host is like a MPDSA host. It can send the data or the VSA bus. The IT6161 will convert the data to HDMI. Like they have a protocol, internal protocol standard layer, where all the data lanes must be converted to TDMI signals, like for the HDMI display to monitor, to process basically. This is one kind of a converter bridge example. There is a multi-output bridge, as I said before. This is a real-time example of those bridge. where it takes this bridge will take the lanes data from the DSA host, and it converts and pumps the data to respect to LVDS outputs. At a time, it can thrive through LVDS outputs. So the lane switching can happen internal to this bridge, and then can send the data based on what host is going to send. There is another bridge called multi-bridge switch. Unlike SN65 DSA4, it can support two output display interfaces, but at a time only one can able to drive the output data. So the user can able to switch the display interface by using some MIPI switch inside to this bit basically. This is another example of those kind of a bridge. What I mentioned before, this is internal implementation. Take an example of some kind of a bridge switch that takes the data from the Samsung host, and it can thrive through to different bridges. One bridge for LVDS output and another bridge is for HDMI. This bridge switch, MIPI switch, is going to switch the data. Like there would be a data enable pin or even a select pin. So it can thrive the data coming from the particular host to the respective bridge at a time, because it's we can able to access the single bridge at a time basically. That this is an example of hardware connection on that respective use case. The final is the last bridge is like the bridge that is exclusively used for projectors that I mentioned in earlier, that is like DLP projectors. Similar to what the converter does, but here the DLP 3433 can take the data from the host, but the data need to convert from DSA to DMD. Like the data we are processing to projectors, we call it as a DMD data, unlike LVDS and DPI. This particular DMD data can be driven from the DLP 3433. So the internal ICs can able to take care of those data, and that can send the data to the projector, and the projector will glow basically. What it mentioned clearly, like the master of this particular system is the DLP 3433. It can act to thrive the data and convert the data of DSA to DMD to process the projector lens. That is what the overall a picture of this particular bridge is basically. Let us talk about how these bridges has been implemented in software perspective, like in Linux DRM subsystem. Basically, if you want internal details, how this Linux DRM bridge subsystem is have a stack, there is a big stack basically, how this DRM core is registering to DRM host drivers, how this DSA host drivers are registering DSA core, DRM panel, and DRM bridge, something like that. There's a big functional block diagram that has already been discussed in the last Linux conferences by me. If you want any information on that respective regards, please take a look and look into this particular slides, where you can able to understand the overall overall perspective of those DSA and DRM subsystems, how they look basically. Because most of the DSA subsystem is similar to what I discussed before, except from API changes in recent kernels. But apart from that, the entire block diagram that I mentioned earlier, like how the DRM panel works with respect to bridge, and how DRM bridges works with respect to DRM panels, and how the host bridge is listening to DRM subsystem, and how the host DSA bridge is listening to DSA core, is something very similar to what we have right now. A little bit about the DRM bridge basically. like DRM bridge is one of the component of Linux DRM. Slowly this is one of the prospect to have been introduced in the mailing list, so that the IDA is to move the encoder drivers towards the bridge side, because bridge has its own advantages. Basically, in the Linux perspective, bridge is something like a tree. Like each tree has a tail, so each bridge has its own bridge. The bridge always start from the encoder. Say for example, the pure bridge driver should have one encoder, that is a head. So what are the bridges that are connected in that pipeline should have bridge forward by bridge forward by bridge. Take an example of a host in the Samsung DSA. Host is a bridge. If I wanted to connect another bridge, say for example, host bridge is called as a host with a bridge A. And second bridge, if I wanted to add IT 6162, that convert the DSA to HDMI. So that can be called as a bridge B. And each bridge can have its own connector, like bridge connectors. And that bridge can output to another bridge, like or it can be a panel. But in the panel also, we treat it as a panel bridge, basically, instead of having a direct panel. It's panel bridges is software implementation of panels, which are downstream in the bridge, basically. What I mean to say here was like there should be encoder first. That encoder can be a dump encoder. So earlier that encoder has encoder operation, but right now there is no encoder operation. Just exposed to user space that there is an encoder to understand the legacy use case, but the encoder here is a dump. But what are the subsystems followed by the encoders should be treated as a bridges. So each bridge connected as a tree fashioned area. Bridge A, bridge B, bridge C, something like up to song, basically. That is how this particular slide is has been prepared, basically. Earlier there was a DRM encoder. If there is no bridge at all, the each frame buffer is connected to CRTC, and that CRTC connected to encoder, and the encoder connected to connector, something like that. But with the DRM bridge, but what I mean to say is each encoder, we do have a multiple encoders, because each and every pipeline, video pipeline area, we call it as encoders. But here we call it as a bridges to understand the bridge topology. We do have a bridge connector. Those we don't have a earlier DRM connectors that can be easily replaced with bridge connectors. So what are the bridges having a connectors? Connectors can have a several advantages with respect to hard pluggable. The connectors have a flag, something like EDID in HDMI, and connectors we don't need a connector, something like that. Though the bridge connectors has some advantages while handling the bridges alone, basically. So the overall what I meant to say was like if you want to write a new driver in the Linux DRM, the drivers need to have some kind of a bridge structures rather than the encoder structure in our nodes, basically, due to the framework changes in the recent discussions and driver changes. So let us discuss more about how these several bridges has been implemented in Linux DRM bridge using DRM bridge APIs, like how the drivers has been written, basically. I will give you the clear overview, and most of the drivers look similar, but internal register handling might differ, but the main core protocol standard is the same. As I said, this bridge subsystem implementation is going to be more mature, because we do have several issues like what other stacks do have, but it's ongoing work, and it can give some information about how these bridges are working, at least from my perspective. Let us talk about host bridge. The first one, I have categorized into three different areas, like how the physical connection is going to happen, and how those physical connections are connected in the DTS, in the device tree. So if it is a device tree, how we are going to write the particular bridge driver Linux to access their downstream bridges as well as upstream encoders. Let us talk about host bridge. The host here, a physical connection of Samsung DSA host. That host, you can directly connect to DSA panel, like you can able to send the video data via those panel. And you can even send, you can even connect that host with some kind of a DSA bridge, as I mentioned before. The bridge, we can have a converter bridge, or it can be a DLP bridge, or it can be bridge switch, something like that.
Yeah.
That is how the physical connection is going to have, basically. In the device tree pipeline, we have a LCD interface node. That node has an output port. That port can connect to DSI. And the DSA port has one input that is connected to LCD interface. The output of the port can be a panel, or it can be a bridge. If it is a bridge, it's just two outputs. One input is DSI host, and the output could be a panel or some kind of encoder, or even some kind of HDMI connector, something like that. Here in case, we have a Ampere 1280 simple panel. So this is a bridge perspective of how this DSA is host handling. But in case of panel, we don't have any port on the output panel, because the port is the end of the terminal, basically. And as I said, the DPI, we do have a pipeline in the DSA host node to attach pendle the DPI. So how this particular host bridge driver is going to write, or what are the different protocols or different areas you need to look into it? First one is a probe area. Here we need to host. When I say host, we should have host ops. The host ops operation need to hook, and we need to register the bridge, because it is itself is a DSA host itself is a bridge, so you need to register it as a bridge. In the host attach, we do have a, by listing the bridge, we do have a bridge operations and host operations. In the host attach, we do have a MIPI DSA attach, and that attach can trigger the slave bridge or slave panel, basically. So from there you can find there is a panel connected to the DSA host, or there is a bridge connected to the DSA host, something like that. I will give those probing overview in the next slides, but more or less the driver looks the same on the probe area. And we have a bridge attach. Once you find the panel from the bridge, you need to find the panel, and even we need to find the panel from the host attach, but it's one of the advantages, basically. And let us talk about how host bridge attach, like whether it could be the downstream bridge or downstream panel. The panel can ask about MIPI DSA attach, so the host attach will get probed, and it can find out that there is a slave panel or slave host bridge is connected. So host can identify there is the slave is connected, basically. Assuming the connection is about panel. So once it finds that there is a panel, the pipeline starts from the LCD interface. It start attaching the each and every pipeline. It start attaching the bridge, like in the host bridge. And it can attach panel bridge, because here in case, the panel, we call it as the panel bridge in the bridge perspective. If it is a bridge that is connected to a panel, from there the data transfer happened in the host transfer area, like the panel sends the data to the host via DSA command, something like that. If it is a direct panel, the host attach identifies the panel, so it can create a panel bridge. So host bridge attach is happened. All the bridge attach has done. Once all the bridge attach is done, the host is start sending the data to the panel, and their panel communicate the data. That is how it is done in the transfer call. Let us talk about the converter bridge. In this converter bridge, we have physical connection of about Allwinner and X50, DPI, Allwinner host bridge. Host controller can be, but we need to have a bridge, bridge support to, in order to handle the bridges. So I can connect IT6161 bridge, where it can convert IPRX data to HDMI-TX. The pipeline looks similar to before, but here in case, there is one fundamental difference is like this type of bridge, we need to interface with I2C. Like the slave can be interfaced by I2C, but the actual data transfer can go into happen those lanes basically. That is how the pipeline is going to have going to create. The TCON can output the DSA, DSA output to IT6161, and IT6161 output to HDMI connector. Okay. The IT6161 input to DSA output, DSA output to HTCON input, something like that. There is no host ops because it's not a host bridge. It's a purely a converter bridge, that is a slave bridge. So we need to pass the bridge. Some of the bridges has been passed in the probe, but it can able to pass the bridge. We can pass the bridge and identify there is a bridge, IT6161 bridge. So create the bridge ops and add the bridge and attach the PDSA attach. But in this case, the host will attach will get scanned. From there, the actual data transfer is going to happen in the bridge operation perspective. The host operation still exists, but it cannot be directly proportional like what you have in a host bridge. So all this command communication is done by I2C commands. So it can configure I2C commands and do the data transfer by sending the configured commands. Why I'm crossing the host ops is like I'm crossing the host transfer call, because transfer is not required in this particular slave bridge perspective, because in order to send the I2C config data, we need to have a bridge operations. But in DSA commands, we need to have a host transfer. The next one is a multi-output bridge that is similar to what we have discussed so far. And we do have, but here in case we need to probe the two different panels and switch the panels and outputting those panels into their communication overview. As I said before, the probe will identify the panels and understand there is a panel has, identify the bridge, understand there are the panels. So created a panel bridge attach, panel bridge add, and try to hook the bridge ops and host ops. Once the pipeline is attached, host need to, slaves are sending data via I2C. Host can take those data transfers and pump the video signal to the respective panels. This is how the actual 84 two different LVDS has been taken care of. Then there is another bridge, that is multi-out switch bridge. Similar to SN84, 6484, but in this particular switch, we can turn on the switch in particular connection and turn off the switch. We cannot access the both at the same time. This is one of the use case where industrials want to have a common LVDS connector, and sometimes they wanted to take the data in the HDMI connector, something like that. So this LT8912 has an internal bridge, MIPCSA switch implementation. So it can take care of enabling the particular paths and disabling the other parts, something like that. There is a driver, pardon me, I have mistaken the slides. There is a driver in the Linux kernel with 89.12, but it do support HTML, but I'm not sure whether it is supporting LVDS at the same time. But actual bin switching is still under implementation. You can able to get those information in the coming slides. Yes, this is a internal point of view what I have discussed in the earlier slide, like multi-out switch. This is what internally happened basically. The host DSI can send the data transfer to the respective protocol interfaces in the form of conversions like HDMI, DSI to HDMI, DSI to LVDS, something like that, with the help of MIPI DSI switch. And right now I'm working on to try to connect this particular pipeline. Since the pipeline can access only one output, but here we have two outputs, you need to have a switch to implement those outputs, basically. This particular use case still under discussion. Since I have been invoking the thread, is still under working process. What I want to go into achieve is like, I need to create a pipeline where output of DSI, basically output of DSI is single, like we can access only port one with only one endpoint. But here I need to access two bridges in the form of two endpoints with single port one, and alter those ports based on the HDMI interrupt or based on some kind of a hard pluggable interrupt so that the switch is going to happen. I'm not sure whether this particular thing or particular future is going to enable or accept by the main, but there is a challenging to make this switch into pipeline stream because it is very hard to include a non-video thing to video pipeline, something like that. That is where I have been still in the discussion, basically. The final bridge implementation of DLP bridge. This is how the similar what we have so far with I2C bridges. This particular bridge, but this particular bridge will convert the DSI data to DLP preceptor. Similar to what we have in normal converter bridges, but instead of connecting standalone panel, we need to connect a projector. Even in the layers perspective, projector is also called as a simple panel. So we need to have a projector timings, like what you have a display timings in the panel side. So we need to identify those timings and we can attach those timings into the pipeline. We can treat it as a panel simple. So the output of the DSI is connected to input of the DLP VC3433. Output of DLP C3433 is connected to DMD projector, like it's a simple panel. Once the pipeline is established, once it identifies a projector, it can establish the pipeline, start pipeline attaching, and the actual data transfer is always going to happen in via I2C commands. Yeah, I have this library right now is under implementation. I've sent it on mainline. I need to resolve some comments to make it more proper to upstream. Let us discuss the last topic about how this bridges has been probing. This is one of the section where lot of stack implementation require like incompatibilities, because DSI probing is more difficult because due to its lack of enumeration, unlike HDMI and others. But this particular DSI probe has been lot of things need to take care in order to do probe, because we need to understand the pipeline and we need to create a proper pipeline setup in order to probe the pipeline devices, something like that. Let us talk about how this probing is happened in a pure bridge. A pure bridge, it can be host bridge or it can be a slave bridge. But it cannot be a direct panel, that's what I'm saying. So the pure bridge, we can connect a simple panel And even you can connect that pitch with a HDMI connector. Even that panel, we can connect another LVDS encoder or another DP encoder, something like that. That is what I call it as a pure bridge. Apparently, there was IT 6161, which basically I have mistaken that part here. Sorry. So the pipeline, as I mentioned it, LCD interface is connected to DSA, Samsung DSA host, Samsung DSA connected to IT6161 bits, something like that's okay. So in the probe starting point of view, what do you mean by probe? Like the slave probe of IT6161. It's trying to attach the host. So host will find out whether there is a bridge is connected or a panel is connected. But here, this slide is strictly connected to bridge. So I found the bridge, IT6161 bridge. Once it found the bridge, the host ends and the probe ends, but actual pipeline of the bridge attach will start from the LCD. That pipeline attach will internally called as a Samsung host attach. That internal cost as a slave attach, IT6161 attach. So all this bridges attachment is something like stacking the individual bridges. If you see, all this bridge chain is going to happen like in a stack. The bridges that gets pushed last can get enabled first, like each and every bridge has a bridge operations. So those operations can be triggered in a stack fashion. So in the right side, we have for example, we have connected HDMI connector. HDMI connect is the last one in the stack, so it gets started like bridge operations of HDMI enable, pre-enable started, and those enable will start IT6161, those enable will start DSM6161, those enable will start with MXFP, something like that in the stack fashion. If you connect a bridge is a simple normal panel, it can treat it as a panel bridge. The panel bridge enable call it as a IT6161 enable and DSM enable and MXFP enable, something like that. That is how the probing is happening basically. In a simple panel, we have a panel that is attached basically. It cannot be a panel bridge, it can be a direct panel, STC, the ground zero panel. So the panel start attaching the host. Host identifies the panel. Okay, there is a panel. Attach it and vent, and LCD interface start attaching, and it can start the Samsung bridge attach, and it can finally attach the panel bridge attach. Something that is how the internal pipeline attach is going to happen basically. So those panel attach will call it as a panel operations. Since it is not a simple panel, it's going to call the panel operations of ST7770. The main fundamental differences between the bridge probe versus panel probe is like we don't have a exclusive bridge driver here. The panel bridge itself acts as a bridge here basically. From the Linux DRM bridge point of view, panel bridge is a virtual bridge for those who are connected as a panels to be treated as a bridge, something like that. This is how the physical connection of my various bridges on my setup. There are many, but these are the typical ones I have gathered basically. The left one is more or less as a normal bridge with Alvinder, and the middle one is like a SN6584 DSA bridge. The last one is a typical DLP bridge basically. So far, these are the bridge implementations. I'm trying to segregating all these stuffs to the mainline. If you have any specific questions on this respective work on my contributions, you can easily shoot an email, and we have even the QR code WeChat. If anyone wants to connect me, can connect via this. There are a couple of things still under mainline because of various blockages. I'm still working on it. Yes, I'm trying to close them as soon as possible. to move the further. And there are a couple of things already been upstreamed basically to support Bridges functionalities in order to understand all these pipeline constraints. That is how overall work of my thing is happen. If you have any specific questions, and please let us know via email and WeChat. I'm here to help. Thank you. Thanks for your patience. Goodbye.